Okay, so after some thought, we could do it this way and just create a bunch of if statements. So if user chose odd and user chose, well, if the call was odd and the throw was odd from the user and the CPU was even, then we could do another if statement switching these two, and then another if statement if the user chose even and the computer chose even and the user chose even, then the number's even. Or if the user, so anyway, it seems to me like that's a complicated way of doing it. And so this happens sometimes in programming where we run into a wall and we're saying, I really don't like the way this is going down. It's just starting to get a little too complicated. I wanted to show the being able to choose a random string for the computer just to show how to do that. But really, we could just have the computer choose a number, and then we could have the computer and the user choose a number. And we wouldn't have to mess around with odd or even, and then we can just add the numbers and then decide whether it's an odd or even number, right? And so that's kind of what I'm thinking. I'm going to take and back out this code. So I'm going to back out this if statement that decides who wins the round. I'll leave the comment in there because we'll need that. I'm going to even back out this random choice for the computer. And I'm backing them out rather than changing because I think it'll get confusing on the video. And then I'm going to leave in where we ask the user to call odd or even, but then I'm going to take out this information where we're asking for the throw. Okay? So what we've got now is we're asking the user to call it odd or even, but then we're going to ask for the throw. But now, instead of asking for the throw as a word, we're going to say, do you want to throw a one or a two? Okay, and then they're going to bring in their input. Well, the problem is if I use that same variable now, user throw, and set it equal to in.nextInt, I'm going to get an error when I compile saying user throw is a string, and you're trying to put an int into a string. You can't do that. Well, so I'm gonna have to go up and modify my variables now. So the user throw and the CPU throw are now gonna be ints, which means I can't set them equal to a string. I have to set them equal to zeros now. And then I won't need the temp variable for the CPU random number anymore because I'm going to be storing that in the throw, right? Hopefully this isn't getting confusing to modify, but this happens as you go through and look at your code and say, I can do this a better way. Then I'm going to do it this way. So the only call or the only string is going to be the call, whether it was odd or even. Okay. And then we'll still do the check to make sure they entered an odd or even. Well, then I'm going to do a one or a two. I'm going to need a similar check to see, make sure it was a one or a two. They can't just put any old number in there. So check for valid user selection. And then I'm going to need to have this a similar kind of loop. So while, and then what's the condition? Well, while the user throw is not equal to a one, now I can use the not equals because I'm not using a string anymore, I'm using a number. So while the user throw is not equal to a 1, and the user throw is not equal to a 2. If it's not one of those things, then I'm going to system.out.println and say you need to select a 1 or 2, try again. And then read in their input again, user throw equals in.nextInt. And now we'll only get out of this loop if they pick a 1 or a 2. Well, we've got a 1 or a 2, and then we're going to make a random choice for the computer. So I can say, let's see, it's called CPU throw is the name of the variable. So I'll come back down and say CPU throw is going to be equal now to a random number. So I'm going to say r.nextInt out of 2. The problem is that will give me a 0 or a 1. And really what I want the computer to be picking is a 1 or a 2. So how do I turn a 0 or a 1 into a 1 or a 2? And the answer is after we've gotten the random number, we just add 1 to it. and that will give us a 1 or a 2 to get our random number. And so now the computer's made its choice. There's no if statements there. And this, to me, is looking a little cleaner. Okay. Well, before we decide who wins the round, we need to decide whether the number was even or odd. So let's think about this for a minute. Isn't that the next step? I've kind of lost our pseudocode for a little bit. We have to decide whether the number was odd or even, right? And so what are we going to do? Well, what are our choices? If both the computer and the user pick a 1, then we get a 2, right? If the computer and the user both pick a 2, then that's a 4. And if the computer picks 1 and the user picks the other, then we're going to get an even number of 3. So those are our choices, 2, 3, or 4. So how can I determine whether it was even or not? Let's think about this for a second. We need some way of identifying whether it was an even number. So down here, we can say if the choice, so if the user call dot equals ignore case even, so if the user chose even and the number was even, this is still the dilemma. Excuse me. The dilemma we're trying to solve is picking whether the number was odd or even. Well, we could do that just by saying and the combination and the user, so we could get back into another kind of nasty if statement. But what I'm thinking is maybe we just ought to create a variable to hold the total and then make a decision based on that. So I'm going to come back up to the top where I'm declaring my variables, and I'm going to create a variable that I, in my mind, just kind of groups together with these throws. I'm going to create one called throw total, and I'll set it equal to 0 to begin with. But then down here in the program, I can set the throw total equal to the user throw plus the CPU throw. Okay, so now we've got a throw total that's going to either be 2, 3, or 4. So now I can make a decision about whether it's odd or even based on that throw. And so what I'm thinking is I can just create a variable. It's either going to be even or not, right? So what I'm thinking is maybe best would be to create a Boolean variable that stores whether there's an even number or not. Is that the best way to do this? I'm not only trying to think of the best way to do it, I'm trying to think of the best way not to confuse everybody. I need some way of determining whether this throw total is odd or even. So I could now say, if user call equals ignore case even and throw total equals a 2, then that's a win, right? But I'm thinking I could just take it one step further and decide whether the number's odd or even. But I don't have, there's no such thing as an odd or even variable, but there is a Boolean variable. And so follow me on this one, and hopefully this makes sense. What I'm thinking is let's create a Boolean variable. Again, I'll maybe come up here and say Boolean. And just call it, I can pick one of the two, it doesn't matter, it can be even or odd, but I'll just say even equals false to begin with. So this, well, maybe I'll say is odd, how about that? Instead of even, I'll say is odd, and I'll set that equal to false to begin with. Now, this is odd variable is going to contain a true or a false. If it's false, that means it's even, right? And if it's true, that means it's odd. That's the idea here. So true equals odd, false equals even. Okay? Are we following along okay? So then I'll come down into this program and say, so decide whether the number was odd or even. After I've gotten the throw total, I'll say if the throw total was equal to a 2, or if the throw total was equal to a 4. That's all we should be able to get, is a 2, 3, or 4. Then what do we want to do? Well, we want to set the isOdd variable equal to false. If the throw total equals a 3, then we want to set isOdd equal to true. Okay? And now we've got that stored in a variable. So now we're setting whether it is an odd number or wasn't an odd number based on the totals. Well, now in our if statement, we can say if the user call equals ignore case even and it's not odd. This will make more sense if I do the odd first. So if the user's choice was odd and is odd, and I could say as and is odd equals a true. Maybe that's less confusing, but normally we'd just say and is odd because it already contains a true or a false. So this is either going to be a true or a false, and so we don't need to say is odd equals true. We can just say is odd in the case of a Boolean variable only. So if the user call equals ignore case odd and it is odd, then we can print out system.out.println user wins. And then what do we want to do with the total? Well, we want to increment the number of user wins. If the user call, and I set these up in these statements, right? If the user picked odd and the number was odd, or the user picked even and the number was even. So I probably ought to add the or on there. So I'm going to take it and close this in parentheses. Not because I have to, but because I want to. If it's odd, the call was odd, and the number was odd, then that's a win. That's one situation. Or if the user call equals ignore case even, and it wasn't odd. It is not the case that it's odd. Either of those situations is a user win. Okay, and then it's just going to be the opposite for the other side. If the user chose even and the number was odd, I forgot to put an opening parenthesis on there. Or the user call was odd and the number wasn't odd. If either of those situations are true, then that means that system.out.println, the computer wins. And then we can increment the number of computer wins. And that's kind of our two scenarios, right? Okay, well, we'll come back in the next video and try to wrap this up. Spencer out.